to love in a man's heart. In the secret of my heart, teach me wisdom. Do not drive me out of your sight. Do not take from me your Holy Spirit.
For our hatred. Turn aside from evil and do good. Seek and strive after peace.
Holy, holy, holy. the sad to Jesus if you have been here. My brother would not have died. Even now I know that whatever you ask of God, God will grant you. Jesus said, your brother will rise again.
I am the resurrection of life, and he who lives in me will never die.
Jesus saw Mary and her companions weeping. He was greatly moved. Where have you laid him? He asked. And they replied, come and see. And Jesus went.
So before we play three instrumental pieces for you, I do want to mention that there's one of the movements that we did in the Mass is actually not from the Mass for the Lenten season. And perhaps some of you who are big Mary Lou Williams fans might notice that the Sanctus that we did is actually from Music for Peace, or Mary Lou's Mass, which she wrote a little bit later. That was her third Mass that she wrote in 1970. But we chose to use it because she kind of had this evolution in her style of her sacred music writing. And the Mass, when she did the Lenten Mass, was very similar in terms of the melodic line between that Sanctus and the later one. But the later one was a little bit more fleshed out. So we made that decision. So we're going to play three pieces, two by Mary Lou and one by myself that's dedicated to her. And the first one is something that she wrote while she was touring for 12 years with Andy Kirk and his 12 Clouds of Joy. And they were a Kansas City-based early swing band that became very well known, mainly through Mary Lou's compositions and arrangements for the band. And so we're going to play a tune that she wrote during her tenure with Andy Kirk. This is called Lonely Moments.
Thank you.
How about it for, I think we can give them rounds of applause. Tony DePaulis on bass. And Diego Boglino on drums. So I want to make sure to mention that these three pieces we're doing tonight are all on my new recording, Force of Nature, which we do have here this evening. I'm really excited to really, as I mentioned in the pre-concert talk, to not just have the book about Mary Lou, but to have a recording so that people can hear these kind of new arrangements, bringing Mary Lou's really forward-thinking compositions into a new era. So I'm happy to sign those CDs afterwards if anyone wants to purchase them. But this next tune on the recording is something that Mary Lou originally recorded in 1963 on a record called Mary Lou Williams Presents Black Christ of the Andes. And it had her first sacred music on it with a piece that she premiered down the street or over at St. Francis Xavier for St. Martin de Porres, who was the first person of color to be canonized in the Catholic Church. And on that same album, she did several trio selections, and this one of them we're going to play for you now, she dedicated to the late John F. Kennedy right after his assassination, and this is called Dirge Blues.
Thank you.
You feel it on that one, right? So Mary Lou, you know, always said her music was rooted in the blues, even though she also identified herself very specifically as being an experimental composer, and I think you really hear that in that piece. So we're going to close this little mini trio set with the title track from my new recording, Force of Nature, and this is something I wrote for Mary Lou Williams. As I'll mention for those of you who missed it in the pre-concert talk, the title of this came from someone where I'm living now in Pittsburgh, and I moved there a couple years ago. And before I moved there, I had spent about 7 weeks there just kind of doing some research on Mary Lou because she's from there and I had never been there before. So one of the curators of a jazz club there named John Shannon just told me one night that I was a force of nature, and I thought, that sounds like a song title. So I wrote it down, as I often do, trying to collect titles because I think it's very hard to title pieces. And I wrote it on a post-it note and stuck it on the mirror in the room I was renting. And I didn't know what it was gonna be. But later on, when I had the opportunity to do this recording, I thought, I think that's the name of the record. So I actually wrote this piece while I did not have a piano. When I moved to Pittsburgh from New York a year and a half ago, I left my instrument here because it just was an upright that was good for a long time but wasn't worth the cost of moving. And so I now, fast forward, now I have a great Steinway B piano that fans bought for me. But for 11 months I had no instrument. But I realized, so I was living on the same street for a while that Mary Lou grew up on when she was in Pittsburgh. And there was a church a few blocks away, and they let me go there and practice. So I wrote this over two practice sessions at this church in Mary Lou's old neighborhood in East Liberty. And that post-it note became the cover of the recording. So this is called Force of Nature.
Thank you.
Tony DePaulis, Diego Voglino. Actually, while the chorale, well, they're all back in place, but I'll just say a note about these next two pieces. So these two pieces were not part of Mary Lou's Mass for the Lenten season, but they were written just right before her last Sunday that she did the Lenten Mass up in Harlem at St. Thomas the Apostle. Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. was assassinated, and she immediately wrote these two pieces for the youth choir at St. Thomas to sing for him. So they were basically done there, and then they were also, like the Mass, they were done in Rome by a group of seminarians and broadcast over Vatican radio. But really, this piece does get done occasionally by choirs, but not very much. So both these settings are settings of portions of Dr. King's speeches.
Ooh. Wow. Thank you so much. Oh. Can I use this? Is this all right? It seems to work. Okay. Well, again, I want to thank you for being here tonight as we celebrate this amazing and seminal figure of American music and jazz, Mary Lou Williams. We're especially honored to have Deanna Witkowski, the Mary Lou Williams scholar, award-winning jazz pianist, and author of the definitive Mary Lou Williams biography. And of course, Tony and Diego, so great to have you guys. You heard all about how to get your copy of the book back there with Cecilia at the table. and I hope you've taken some time to look at the notes on your program through the QR code, which is provided on our program. There's a sentence I never thought I'd hear myself saying. And I hope you've been heartened to learn more about the fascinating life and work of Mary Lou Williams, and that your spirits have been lifted by her wonderful music, sung by the Stonewall Chorale, the nation's first LGBT chorus. I think Mary Lou would have approved. I'm sure she would have approved. So Mary Lou, that was all for you. And how extraordinarily lucky we are to have Deanna and the band here. So right now, as you know, we're in a very critical, crucial point in history. Every time, every day, we are reading more and more terrible news, whether it's about new COVID strains or rampant racist, misogynistic, and biophobic people in our government for whom the clear stream of reason has indeed lost its way. And then, of course, world events and human suffering, too horrible to imagine. We don't know how all of this will end, and it's hard to be hopeful in such times. I do have hope, though, that the best in humanity will triumph, and we will live in a world where the mind is without fear, because fear is behind so much pain and suffering in this world. Fear of not having enough, fear of people who are different from you, fear of change, fear of other races and sexual orientations, and fear of other people's beliefs, although there is some sanity in that fear. So now, it's your turn to sing. But before we do that, I'd like us to take just a moment of silence to stand in solidarity with the people of Ukraine. There's not much to say, it's just awful and evil what's going on there. But somehow standing together silently seems right at this time. And on this paper that you have, is Deanna's piece called We Walk in Love. And we'll figure out how we're gonna do that in just a second. But I ask you if you would please stand for a moment. There it is. Okay. What we're going to do is we're going to sing the first verse once so you sort of hear how it goes. And then we're going to repeat that verse and you can sing it. Because this is a very inspiring and uplifting piece. And walking in love and promoting peace is something to do. So please join in with us when after you hear the first stanza.